Thank you, Joel. Hello, everyone. Good evening and Shana Tova. I'm Lori Kirkpatrick, Community Involvement Coordinator for Jewish Gateways. And I want to welcome you to this unusual and important gathering of our community. We come together tonight to create a circle of warmth and light at a dark, daunting time. I know we are all carrying grief and losses from the pandemic, political fears, racial and environmental reckonings. We also suffer from the injury and absence of our rabbi, Bridget Wynn, who is home and resting, recovering from a fall. All of this sits very heavy in our hearts. At such moments, we can find strength by returning to traditions and rituals, hearing Jewish wisdom in new ways, and feeling the collective power of meditation and prayer. As someone who has been a hub behind the scenes for this last week, I can say that a large number of us have been working very diligently to maintain this Rosh Hashanah celebration despite Rabbi Bridget's absence. In the spirit of this holiday and our community, we are confident that you will be patient if we experience any unexpected glitches. Rabbi Bridget's good friend, Rabbi Ruth Adar, has generously donated so much time and energy to lead us tonight. She has been a delight. Everyone involved has worked overtime, attempting things they've never done before, rising into new skills. Online Shabbat has continued with volunteers. Family services will take place. This is a very personal and beautiful community. Today, through her wife and son, Rabbi Bridget sent us these messages. Her desire to be with us, her appreciation for everyone's hard work, especially Rabbi Ruth's, and her wishes for a sweet new year. In our Musar classes, Rabbi Bridget teaches us that each person must find their own special gifts, their strengths and talents, and contribute them for the good of everyone. Never is this lesson more true than in a time of crisis. Thank you for being a part of this Rosh Hashanah evening. And please allow me to introduce Rabbi Ruth Adar.
Thank you, Lori. I am so privileged to be welcome. I have felt wonderfully welcomed into this community. And I've been struck by how, frankly, how little ego I have encountered through this whole thing. Everybody has done their best to make things happen. When somebody's lost a link, other people step up to help. It is just a beautiful, beautiful community, and it is a credit to Rabbi Bridget, but also to each of you. Sometimes people will say after a beautiful service, they'll come to the rabbi and they'll say, oh, Rabbi, it was so beautiful. But the thing is a service is built by everybody who participates, by the committee of people who make it happen and who make all the wheels and gears go together, by the people who work behind the scenes to make things happen, by the people who raise money to make things happen, by all the little pieces, and by the community that comes together with hearts and souls, lifting all that up in prayer. So I'm honored to be here with you tonight and to be with you for the High Holy Days. We certainly will pray for Rabbi Bridget and for anyone else in the congregation who is recovering or suffering from illness or accident. Okay. But I just want to encourage you to appreciate yourselves and this beautiful community tonight. This is truly, as Jacob found when he was in the Bible, when he was in a place that he came to appreciate as a holy place. He said, this place was holy and I didn't know it. This community is holy. And I hope that by the end of this High Holy Days, we will all know each other much better. I'd like to encourage you that if you need tech help, you can chat to the hosts. You can just put a message in the chat box and they can help you. If you will feel more connected with your camera on, I encourage you to keep it on. If that is just too horrible a thought, don't worry about it. You're welcome to leave your camera off. Please feel free to take a break if you need a break. Nobody is standing aside with a little notepad going, okay, who's the bad Jew here? We're all good Jews here, or we're good friends of Jews here, and we're good families of Jews here. So don't worry about that. Take care of yourself however you need. I do ask that you remember that when you're not going to be speaking, to mute yourself, because that can get a little bit exciting. So I encourage you now, Joel, who is going to be leading us, Joel Siegel is going to be leading us with the music this evening. And he's going to be singing Hine Matov, Behold How Good. And feel free to sing along while you're muted on Zoom.
In a moment, we'll hear actually a group effort, a pre-recorded Hine Matov. This is the group that I've been calling the Jewish Gateway's Tabernacle Choir, which is open to new members, by the way. And right now it consists of Scott Williams and Sarah Williams and Dave Pond and Cheryl Cleary and me. And I think that's everybody, I hope. And if I've left you off, this is why I never say names in these public things, because I'm deathly afraid of leaving them off. I want to say before we begin my own just few words. I promised them I wouldn't go more than 25, 30 minutes. I'm overflowing with gratitude this evening, and I did not expect to be, certainly not last week. I'm going to share, I'm hoping it's not oversharing, but I had a major depressive attack a couple weeks ago, and it kind of sits on you when it happens. Those of you who know this situation, I'm sure understand it. And last week, of course, came the news that Rabbi Bridget had fallen, and we didn't know yet what was going to happen in terms of our service. I'm first of all immensely grateful to hear encouraging things from Julia and from Avi about Rabbi Bridget's health and her state. She's resting as she needs to. She's recovering, and every indication is that we're going to be okay. And I'm in kind of this inside outside position in the community. And I have watched what Lori was talking about. Hearing some crosstalk voices. If you're not muted, please mute. I have watched this community pull together. I've watched people, as Lori said, pick up the ball in maybe ways that they were not used to, or outside of, or in their comfort zone. And by a week later, it was handled. I called Julia right before we started. I said, I'm not calling you because of a crisis. I'm not calling because I need anything. I'm just calling to wish you Shana Tova and tell you everything is fine and it's handled. And I am amazed to be part of this amazing, of this community, and to see the leadership. I've been saying it is a tribute to leadership when the leader can make herself temporarily dispensable. And that's what Rabbi Bridget has done. She has nurtured and empowered a community for 10 years that when something popped up and she was unable to be with us, we picked up the ball and we got it done. So just tremendous gratitude to Rabbi Bridget, Rabbi Ruth, Lori, and the entire team. I'm not going to say all the names because I will leave you out, and I don't want to do that. Just thank you. Thank you. Thank you. So much gratitude. If Christine has it queued up, we can listen to and sing along with Hinei Mah Tov.
Matovu manaim shevet achim gam yachad. Hine matovu manaim shevet achim gam yachad. Hine matov shevet achim gam yachad. Hine mah tov shevet achim gam yachad. Hine mah tov umanaim shevet achim gam yachad. Hine mah tov umanaim shevet achim gam yachad. Hine mah tov shevet achim gam yachad. Hine mah tov shevet achim gam yachad. Hine mah tov umanaim shevet achim gam yachad.
So how good it is when a community can come together like this and enjoy time together. This is the Jewish New Year, Shana Tova. That means a good year in Hebrew, and it's the way you say Happy New Year in Hebrew. But we've also got some families who are here, some individuals rather, who are here to share the words Happy New Year in other languages. Michelle Liedeker, could you tell us how to say Happy New Year in Mandarin?
Besimcha. We'll say, Xinnian Kuaila.
Xinnian Kuaila.
Wonderful. And Molly Freeman, will you tell us how to say Happy New Year in Armenian?
Shinor Havor Nor Dari. May the new year be full of grace.
Thank you, Molly. I think that's the first Armenian I've ever heard. And Naomi Weiser Green, would you share Happy New Year with us in Indonesian, please?
Selamat Tahun Baru.
Beautiful. Shana Tova to all of you. Now we're going to take a minute to have breakout rooms. You'll be sent to a small room with a few other households. You're not lost. You haven't been cast into outer darkness. This is not a facilitated breakout room. It's just a little quick check-in, a chance to say Happy New Year and what brought you here, maybe to make some new friends. So I encourage you to turn on your video or screen if that's okay. If it's not, that's okay too. And there's a timer at the top of the screen. So don't forget to unmute and keep an eye on the timer. We'll give you a 2.5 minute warning and we'll bring you back here in 5 minutes.
Okay.
And if we all can stay in the center room, Christine and me and maybe Rabbi Ruth, and cover a couple tech matters, that'd be great. Okay. We will check all the recordings before Yom Kippur, but that was something that we probably should have checked beforehand.
I thought that I played that for my sound check. Did I not?
I may not have been paying attention. I mean, I was listening for whether sound existed, not which track it was.
Got it. All right, let's.
That's good.
Okay, good.
Do we have Return Again in Hashivenu? That's on slide number 5. Okay.
Yeah, that was just a freak accident because there are so many different versions of that in a montage.
And we know that Chazak is right, and that's all we have for tonight. Excellent. Okay, super. Thank you.
Yeah, Chazak, there's only one of, so that's got to be right. If it's there, it's got to be right. I'm very sorry about that, Joel. I will fix it.
No problem.
Well, I'm glad to know we've gotten the glitch of the evening behind us.
Don't say that. That's what they said on Apollo 13.
5 seconds. People are coming back.
On Apollo 13, they had a problem in orbit, and they said, okay, we've just had our glitch.
True. Okay, I take it back. And Kena Hora.
There we go. None of that Ena Hora stuff.
Okay. So people are coming back from the breakout rooms. And we've got a High Holy Day melody to enjoy. And I will hand this off to Joel for that part of the service.
Let's, Rabbi, not everybody is back yet. So let's just give them a couple of seconds. And I'll let you know as soon as everybody is back. We're good to go.
Thank you. A little overeager here.
No, you're fine. I love it. We're good to go whenever you're ready, Joel.
Okay, welcome back, everybody. We're going to spend a couple minutes either learning or reviewing a tune you're going to hear a whole bunch over the next 10 days. This is when I, many years ago, I started with a cantor, my cantor, in fact, in Los Angeles, and he said, if you were stuck in a dungeon somewhere with no windows, well, maybe one window that he could barely see out of but could hear sounds through, no calendar, no nothing. He could tell what time of year it was just by listening to the nearby synagogue. Yes, you have to imagine a synagogue standing nearby a dungeon in order for this to work, but these tunes come up and they put us in a mood for a day of the week, a time of the year. And this tune is so old that nobody knows where it comes from or who wrote it. It's why we call it in the Jewish music biz a Mi Sinai tune, which means from Mount Sinai. And that's basically shorthand for we don't know where it comes from. By the way, Yehudit, thank you. I'm not going to be using the chat during the service. Contact me after the service, after Shana, text me. You have my email and number, and you can join up with the Jewish Gateways Tabernacle Choir. Anybody else, you can do the same. Here's that tune. I'm going to do the whole thing, and then I'm going to do little bits of it because it can happen in many different permutations. La, 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 la. that's the longest version, and you can do different parts of it. For example, la 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 la. And many lengths in between. You'll hear that a whole bunch over the next several days.
Now we're going to be talking about the candles. I want to, we're going to visit some three more households for candle lighting. You can also light your candles now if you choose to do so. So our candle lighting visitors are Juliana Wise, who is newly on our steering committee and the Jewish Federation Fellow. So Juliana, will you light candles for us? Okay. And then Jim Galinsky, would you light, please?
Of course.
Jim is in one of our Shabbat dinner people and in the Musar group.
Thank you.
And Ezra Miller and Rhea Ewing, would you light, please? They are Shabbat attendees and Torah study regulars and volunteer at a lot of events.
Yeah, okay, sure. Yeah. Great.
Wonderful. And Joel, would you lead us in the blessings?
I'd be happy to, especially once I unmute. I believe we have a slide. We are skipping the words in red this year, since we are not starting Rosh Hashanah on Shabbat. Baruch atah Adonai, Elokeinu melech haolam, asher kidshanu b'mitzvotav, v'tzivanu lehadlik ner. Lehadlik ner shel yom tov.
And now we're going to follow it with the blessing that we say on great occasions. When something new and wonderful has happened, we have a new year, and this year particularly, we have made it to this time. Those of you who are here, we have had sorrows this year, but we are joyful to be here now. So Joel, will you lead us in Shehechianu?
Absolutely. This is the we made it blessing, and I think we feel it maybe extra poignantly this year. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech Zeman Hazeh.
I forgot to mention that with all blessings, if you say Amen at the end, you get credit for saying the blessing. I think that's a great deal personally. So when we say blessings, you say Amen at the end, and it is as if you said it yourself. Now,
I tried that on my exams, and somehow it didn't work as well when I did that.
Yeah, it doesn't work for other things.
Okay.
So now we have the two of the tunes one tune, Return Again, Hashiveinu, because this song encapsulates some of the feeling of the High Holy Days, that we want to get back to better times and to be better people. And I think that speaks for itself.
Return again, return again, return to the land of your soul. Return again, return again, return to the land of your soul. Return to who you are, return to what you are, return to where you are, born and reborn again, return again, return again, return to the land of your soul.
Gateway's Tabernacle Choir.
Now is the time for turning. To everything there is a season and an appointed time for every purpose under heaven. Now is the time for turning. The leaves are beginning to turn from green to red and orange. The birds are beginning to turn and are flying once more toward the south. The animals are beginning to turn to storing their food for the winter. For leaves, birds, and animals, turning comes instinctively. But for us, turning does not come so easily. It takes an act of will for us to make a turn. It means breaking with old habits. It means admitting that we've been wrong, and this is rarely easy. It means losing face. It means starting all over again. And this is always painful. It means saying, I'm sorry. It means recognizing that we have the ability to change. And this can be embarrassing. These things are terribly hard to do. But unless we turn, we will be trapped forever in yesterday's ways. Therefore, may we find the strength to turn from callousness to sensitivity, from hostility to love, from pettiness to purpose, from envy to contentment, from carelessness to discipline, from fear to trust. May we turn ourselves around and toward all that is noble, true, and life-affirming to revive our lives as at the beginning. Then may we turn toward one another, for in isolation, there is no life. We continue with Baruch Hu.
When we say certain bits of liturgy, the longstanding, that's not a pun, or not an intentional pun, it was an unintentional pun. It has been a standing custom for us to rise at different parts of liturgy, and this is one of them, which has customarily meant to stand up on the feet. Now, not all of us use our legs to get around. And so I learned many years ago from somebody at my synagogue who did get around on wheels instead of on legs. We say we rise in body or spirit. So if you want to stand up on two feet, feel free. If you want to rise on the inside and bring yourself into alignment and ready to praise all that is holy, then I invite you to do so now. We rise in body or spirit for Baruch Hu. Baruch Hu et Adonai Amevorach. Baruch Adonai Amevorach Leolam Vaed. We go to our next slide. We prepare for Shema with this meditation, this musical meditation. Then we'll segue directly into saying Shema together. Open up our eyes. Teach us how to live. Fill our hearts with joy and all the love you have to give. Gather us in peace to you as you lead us to your Shema Yisrael, Adonai Eloheinu, Adonai Echad. Baruch Shem Kevod Malchuto Leolam Vaed.
And next slide. Now we are about to begin the Amidah. Amidah means stand. It is a standing prayer. It is the central prayer. It and the Shema are the two mitzvot encased in the service. I have a reading here I'm going to read for you, And then I encourage you to take a few minutes in silent, private prayer. Praised are you for your wisdom that is hidden, for your dream that we might become people in the fullness of the light. Your dream has become our conscience. May it never be silent in us. May it never be as though we had not heard it. Praised are you for making people responsible for the future of each other. Praised are you who have called, "Where are you? Where is your brother, your sister? Did you give one person to the other for their children to kill each other?" Praised are you for people who hear your word and do it. They are like trees planted by living water. Praised are you for all those who support each other, who give comfort and light, who in their secret way make life easier to bear. Praised are you in those who walk on your path, who do justice and honor the stranger in their midst. Praised are you for nameless people who dare to oppose the cruelties they see because they hope in the day you are preparing when cruelties will end. May the words of my mouth and the stirrings of my heart be received by you, my Redeemer. Let me know your peace. Make peace felt among all the people Israel and all who dwell on earth, that all of us might one day say together, Amen.
Amen.
Pause for a moment for some private prayer.
And if you wish, we rise in body or spirit.
And now we'll continue with the recording of Osei Shalom. Please give us peace.
Osei Shalom Bimroma Uyase Shalom Ale ועל כל יושבי תבל וימרו אמן יעשה שלום, יעשה שלום שלום עלינו ועל כל ישראל יעשה שלום, יעשה שלום שלום עלינו ועל כל יושבי תבל יעשה שלום, יעשה שלום, שלום עלינו ועל כל ישראל. יעשה שלום, יעשה שלום, שלום עלינו ועל כל יושבי תבל. יעשה שלום, יעשה שלום, שלום עלינו ועל כל ישראל.
So, I love Osei Shalom. There are a dozen tunes for it. Some of them are beautiful. Some of them are kind of annoying. Depends on what you grow up with. But the words of it are so beautiful, and we need them so badly in times like this. Some things are true in years, both good years and tough years. Some things are constant. Rabbi Arthur Green wrote that he'd noticed that American Jews tended to observe the high holy days, Passover, and life cycle events, things like bar mitzvah or b'nai mitzvah and baby namings, but not so much the rest of the holidays. Then he said he realized, thinking about it, that Rosh Hashanah is a lifestyle holiday. because we get to it and we say, oh, my goodness, I'm still alive. I'm still here. And we notice who is still here and we notice who is not here. We look around us, we take stock of the past year and we look at the year to come. We mourn our losses, and God knows we have had losses. This has been a very difficult year for many of us. There are people who were around our Rosh Hashanah table or who were at the other end of the telephone who are not there anymore. We face our fears. Our fears coming out of a year like we've had about the year to come. Sometimes we think, well, what more can happen? But we're afraid to say it for fear we'll somehow bring it on. But what we do in these services is we touch base with one another. And that is one of the things that I love about the way this service is designed. Because we do check in with each other. We greet each other at the beginning. We bring different families in to do different parts. We see each other. And I would encourage you to do that with the people in your home and with friends that you see during the High Holy Days, to really see them. Because we're going to move ahead together into the coming year. We don't know what's in it. We just know we're all going together. We can't say, oh no, I like 1973 much better. This is the year we've got, and we're going to make what we can of it. We touch base with one another and we move ahead. As we begin this High Holy Days, I encourage us to check in, get in touch, to repair what we can. There are things that cannot be repaired, and that is sad too. There are things that are broken, and they're just broken. But we can do our best to resolve that this coming year will be a year of the divine spark within us, a year when we will reach inside and say, you know what? There's hope in the world because together we have hope. I wasn't born a Jew. I was born a Catholic back in Tennessee, in case anybody is catching a little funny thing I do to a vowel or two and thinking, is she from Texas or Tennessee? Is she Gore or Bush? Well, I'm neither one. I'm from a different part of Tennessee than Mr. Gore. But I love being Jewish. And one of the things I love about being Jewish is that we're this incredible all-terrain vehicle. And we've been moving through history for thousands of years at this point. Bad things have happened to us. And it's easy to get caught up in thinking just about those. But what I think is amazing about us as a community is that we'll have a truly hideous year or a truly hideous decade. And somehow we join hands, we bind up our wounds, and we move on. We move on and we don't forget to celebrate. We're silly at Purim and we're serious on Yom Kippur. We eat too much at Passover. We make up for it other times of the year, maybe. But this coming year, we will repair what we can, and we will do our best. Each of us, because we hold inside ourselves that divine spark, each human being, it's not just Jews, each human being has the divine spark within them. And if they choose, if we choose, we can let that shine. We can't control anybody else's. That's not in our power. But we can shine and we can reach out to other people who have the same intention. Each of us can do some good in this messy, messy world. And it's hard. I'm not even going to imagine how it could get messier, because you know what? It'll find a way. And that's okay. That's okay. The Jews will keep on moving through history. We will continue to be a mixed multitude, an Erev Rav, such as left Egypt. Not just Jews, but our friends and our families. And we will keep on moving through history. We've done it before. We'll do it again. And we'll try to do some good. We'll try to do better. So may 5782 be a year of things getting better, of us getting better. And may each of us be a blessing to someone else. Shana Tova Metuka, happy Jewish New Year. May we find sweetness in it. May we offer one another sweetness in the year to come. Shana Tova.
Shana Tova. I'm seeing the names of our beloved dead, our beloved departed, for some who are going into the chat. We'll have another chance. You can keep doing that. We can do it again before Kaddish. I'm seeing the name in particular of our dear friend Angela Gold. If you've joined Jewish Gateways recently, you probably wouldn't have met her. She was with us until 2018, excuse me. A dear friend of mine as well, who left the world in May of 2018. Somebody said channeling Angela Gold. If that was directed at me, that's about the highest compliment I could receive. And it's what I try to do whenever I'm with Jewish Gateways. And may we all channel her and her memory and her beautiful music.
Our next prayer is a very famous one. The tune is one of those tunes you can play in a group of Jews, and they'll, if it's not High Holy Days, they'll go, what? Why are we doing this now? This is a signature for the High Holy Days. Avinu Malkeinu means our Father, our King. And that's a little bit problematic because we're living, I hope, in times when at least we have raised some feminist issues and some issues about gender in general. We've left in this particular reading, Avinu Malkeinu in Hebrew. It's not a perfect way of dealing with it, but you can substitute any words you want for it. You can say our parent, our ruler, or you can say, hey, you, person in charge. Or you can say, oh, mystery, because whatever God is certainly a mystery. This is a prayer for our time today. Avinu Malkeinu, open our hearts so that we will see all the things we have been unwilling to see and grow in humility and compassion. Avinu Malkeinu, remove cynicism from our hearts that we may experience and move through despair and hopelessness to be the ones you are calling us to be. Avinu Malkeinu, inspire us to contribute to ending structural and personal racism. Avinu Malkeinu, inspire us to contribute to ending structural and personal heterosexism. Avinu Malkeinu, inspire us to contribute to ending structural and personal sexism. Avinu Malkeinu, inspire us to contribute to ending structural and personal anti-Semitism outside ourselves and within ourselves. Avinu Malkeinu, inspire us to be compassionate to those with whom we disagree. May we see their humanity even when they fail to see ours. Avinu Malkeinu, move us to own our humanity so that we may live what you have taught us, We are all of us, everyone, your creation. Avinu Malkeinu, let us not rest comfortably in the words of these prayers, waiting for you to first act on us, because we must act upon ourselves.
We join together. Avinu Malkeinu, Choneinu Va'aneinu, Avinu Malkeinu, Choneinu Va'aneinu, Ki ein banu ma'asim, Aseh imanu, Tzedakah v'chesed. Aseh imanu, Tzedakah v'chesed, Ve'hoshienu. O Mother and Father of Life, please hear us and give us your grace. O guide deep within us, O hear us and give us compassion and mercy and peace. O guide us through your grace, justice and mercy to all. O guide us and teach us, grant justice and mercy, we shall be free once again. Rabbi Ruth, unmute, please.
Our Father, our King, teach us how we can be better citizens. Our Mother, our Queen, help us atone for our wrongdoings. Our Source and our Destiny, let us return to you wholly and completely. Our Guide and our Truth, teach us how to help those who are ill. Our Father, our King, teach us how to work for freedom for all. Our Mother, our Queen, help us to find our place in your universe. Our Source and our Destiny, help us to learn how to be more loving. Our Guide and our Truth, help us to create a year of abundance and blessing.
O Mother and Father of Life, please hear us and give us your grace. O guide deep within us, O hear us and give us compassion and mercy and peace. O guide us through your grace, justice and mercy to all. O guide us and teach us, grant justice and mercy, we shall be free once again. Aseh imanu, three lines down from the top. Tzedakah v'chesed. Aseh imanu, tzedakah v'chesed, ve'hoshienu.
So now we have reached the Aleinu. Sometimes people ask me when I'm teaching what Aleinu is all about. If you look in a regular prayer book, you'll see that there are lots of versions of Aleinu. And that's because over the centuries, we have had lots of arguments about how to word it. Not surprising, since one way to look at Aleinu is as a kind of mission statement for us as Jews. What is it that we're doing? What's the point? We say it at the end of every service. Although, and that's another thing, the tune sometimes is like, yep, we're in the home stretch now. but it's more than that. It is also something to remind us that we're not just here to feel good or to lick our wounds or to see our friends. We're here to gain energy so that we can go back out into the world and do the work that we have to do. Elenu has many interpretations. It is a prayer that is usually said standing. And when Joel leads us in the musical version of it, that's another one of those rise in spirit or in body, whichever is your preference. I am a rise in spirit person because I travel on wheels, but do what works for you. This meditation on Elenu by Rabbi Rami Shapiro is just wonderful, though. It's one of my favorites. It is up to us to hallow creation, to respond to life with the fullness of our lives. It is up to us to meet the world, to embrace the whole, even as we wrestle with its parts. It is up to us to repair the world and to bind our lives to truth. Therefore, we bend the knee and shake off the stiffness that keeps us from the subtle graces of life and the supple gestures of love. With reverence and thanksgiving, we accept our destiny and set for ourselves the task of redemption.
We rise in body or spirit. Va'anachnu. Koreim umishtachavim umodim lifnei melech malchei hamelachim hakadosh baruch hu kakatuv betoratecha adonahim loch leolam vaed venemar vehaya adonai lemelech al kol haar Bayom hahu, bayom hahu, yihye Adonai echad. Ushmo, ushmo, ushmo echad.
Now we welcome Sandy Warren, who is going to, who will be giving us announcements.
Hi, everyone. I'm Sandy Warren. And before I start with any announcements, I just wanted to thank Rabbi Ruth Adar. I wanted to thank Joel Siegel. And I wanted to thank Christine, who's doing a magnificent job, all three of them, in terms of the service, and Christine with the technical support we need. I also wanted to thank both the Steering Council and the Community Involvement Team, because they have done a phenomenal job of gathering people so we can have this service and taking care of the millions of details that we never get to see because Rabbi Bridget usually handles them. And when she's not here, people had to rise up to help out. And I want to thank all of the people who volunteered to do blessings or candle lighting and will be facilitating later. Just wanted to say thank you. It's part of what makes Jewish Gateways great is the people who make up our synagogue and how much they help everybody. You know, I was interviewing a couple who were involved in Growing Together, our program for families and learning. And when I was speaking to the wife and I said, you know, how did you know Jewish Gateways was for you? And she said, you know, when I came and they were singing songs and I sat down and people were so open and so warm, I just knew I was home. And that really struck a chord in me because in a way, I had spent a large part of my life looking for a synagogue that I could join, something that would feel like home for me. And I had trouble finding it. And finally, in what I thought was serendipity, my wife joined a Musar group and said, we have to go to High Holy Day services. And the next thing I knew, this was a very special place for me. And as I was, the rabbi was preparing a proposal for a foundation, and she asked for a volunteer to help her. And I made the mistake of volunteering. And when I was talking to her, part of the proposal was, can you give us the history of Jewish gateways? And the rabbi told me a story, which I just found fascinating. In 2003, she was an educator for a different synagogue, but so many people were coming up and talking to her and describing how they were having difficulty finding a synagogue that they felt was for them. And the rabbi said to herself, okay, I'm going to rent space and I'm going to set it up so we'll have a potluck Shabbat dinner where people can talk about the things that were bothering them. And she did that. She actually did it for several years. And her thinking was, once people had started to talk and understood more about what Judaism is, they would go back to whatever synagogue they wanted and feel more at home there. And what she found was that wasn't the case. For whatever the reason, people still didn't feel at home. And the rabbi then started Jewish Gateways. And as she put it, it was a gateway to either connect or reconnect to Judaism. And I've always liked that, because I was a person that had to reconnect to Judaism, because for a number of years I had lost my way and just didn't feel a part of it. And it's as I think about it, and we go through all the things that Rabbi Bridget has done to make Jewish Gateways what it is, I think of all the groups that we have. You know, there's a Musar group, there's a Torah study group, we have a salon, we have a coffee and conversation group, we have death cafes, we have Rosh Chodesh for women, with children, without children. We have so many different groups that are getting started. And I just urge each of you, if you can, and I know time can get difficult, but if you can, to try and find a group that fits for you and to try it. And so as I was thinking about what Rabbi Bridget has done for Jewish Gateways and how many people she's done it for, and while I thought it was serendipitous that I stumbled into Jewish Gateways, I learned how much she had wanted to set up an environment where people like myself could become a part of it. And I was thinking, what could we do to maybe at this time help Rabbi Bridget? And I don't know if this is a great idea or not. It came to me, and so I'll throw it out. If it resonates in people, please do it. This is not trying to force you to do anything. But I thought, if I was Rabbi Bridget and I was talking to people after the High Holy Days and said, how did it go? And someone said, you know, everybody contributed a little donation to Jewish Gateways. It's not the amount of the donation. It's the fact that we're all in it together as a community, and we all made a donation. It could be $5. It doesn't matter how much it is. What matters is that we do it together. And so what I would ask you is, if that at all resonates for you, to go to the jewishgateways.org website, and there's a donate button, and that'll get you to a second page where it says donate now. Right under it says tax exempt donation. And I just really would want to encourage people somehow, if I was the rabbi and I heard there was 100 and some people here at Rosh Hashanah and they all had given a little something, to me it would help validate the whole purpose of why I established Jewish Gateways. And so I ask you to do it if you can, and I thank you in advance, and I wish you Shana Tova.
Shana Tova.
Shana Tova, Sandy, thank you.
Thank you so much. That was wonderful. Now we're very near the end of the service, But one of the things that we always do at this point in the service is we remember those who are not with us. The Kaddish prayer is a very ancient prayer. It's in Aramaic. And so if you've ever wondered what Aramaic sounds like, you'll know by the end of this prayer. I invite all of you to unmute yourselves and say names just in a minute. I'll say go and say the names of all the people you want to remember for this year. At this time, I know I have some people I'm thinking of. But I'd like you also to notice something. We say Kaddish not because we're praying for the dead. The dead don't need our prayers. What we are noticing is the mourners. They call it the mourner's Kaddish, the Kaddish Yatom. And the reason is it's part of Jewish mourning practice to see who shows up and has a name to say at Kaddish so that we can look after that person. Now, on a night like tonight, a big holiday, everybody may have names to say, and that's fine. But I'd ask you to think about the fact that it is another expression of our commonality. It's easy to feel like I'm the only person in the world with the troubles I got. But the truth is, we all suffer loss. We have all suffered loss in the last year. And so look around, say your names, and then listen to the other names and realize that you are not alone. So Christine, could you put up the slide with Kaddish on it? And I will lead that prayer. Anybody, before we actually say the names, before we actually read the prayer, feel free to unmute. We're just going to take a minute and listen to the sound of all the names. Don't take turns, just shout them out there.
Rabbi, before we begin.
Kiko, Pineapple,
Grandparents, Father, Patrick West,
Irma, Max Wonder, Tana Friedman, Anna Strapico, Jenny Pito, Lorena Kirschman, Ruben Simon,
Joan Targ, Elizabeth Targ,
Toby Grossman,
John Lewis,
Irving Wilder,
Jacob Newfield.
May all the mourners be comforted among the mourners of Jerusalem.
Amen. Rabbi Ruth, it may have come up in all the names. I need to be unmuted right now. Yesterday, I believe, in the Jewish calendar, marks the first year outside of Justice Ruth Bader Ginsburg. Wanted to give a shout out to her and also to all of us who are remembering Angela Gold tonight.
Remembering who?
Angela.
All right. Now we'll say Mourner's Kaddish. Remember that if you say Amen, it's as good as if you said it. The whole prayer, which is kind of rough going if you've not said it before, but hang in there. We'll get to the end of it together.
And we will. And there, if you're unmuted and want to respond, it'll be bouncing back and forth because we're on Zoom, but that's fine.
Yes. Yitkada.
Yitkada v'yishkabash shmei rabah.
Amen.
Brach hirutei v'yamlich malchutei. Chayechon v'yomechon v'chayei d'kol beit Yisrael. Ba'agala v'zman kariv imru. Amen.
Amen.
Yehei shmei rabah mivrach le'olam v'amei almayim. Yit barach v'yishkabach v'yit pa'ar v'yit romam v'yit nesei. V'yit hadar v'yit haleh v'yit halal. Shemei de kudisha brichu le'ela min kol birchata v'shirata tushbechata v'nechemata da'amiran be'alma v'imru amen.
Amen.
Yehei shlomo rabba min shemaya v'chayim aleinu ve'al kol Yisrael v'imru amen.
Amen.
Osei shalom b'imromav hu ya'ase shalom aleinu ve'al kol Yisrael. Ve'al kol yoshvei tevel, V'imru. Amen.
Amen. Now we're going to have a chance to song. I know this the order says Ruth, Rabbi Ruth intros. I'm going to jump on this one. And it's the song we sang to close last year. And again, the Jewish Gateways Tabernacle Choir has jumped into gear. This was actually all done together last year, except for my part of it. So we get to sing along with our choir. And we're going to do two songs. This song, Chazak, Chazak, Be Strong, and then Lashana Tova. Backing up one slide. Two slides. There we go.
Be strong and let us strengthen one another. Be strong. Let us celebrate our lives. Be strong and let us strengthen one another. Chazak, chazak, v'nit hazek. Chazak, chazak, v'nit hazek. From near and far, to raise our voice in song. And the more we join in the refrain, the more we feel strong. Chazak, chazak, v'nit hazek. That shapes the rest of our lives. For when we return each year, we find a truth we can't deny. Be strong and let us strengthen one another. Be strong and let us celebrate our lives. Be strong and let us strengthen one another. Chazak, chazak, v'nit hazek. Chazak, chazak, v'nit hazek. As we sing, we link ourselves to those who came before, and we're all one with all those yet to come. Our strength, it will endure. Be strong and let us strengthen one another. Be strong and let us celebrate our lives. Be strong and let us strengthen one another. Chazak, chazak. Be strong and let us strengthen one another. Be strong and let us celebrate our strong and let us strengthen one another. Chazak, chazak. Be strong, chazak, chazak. V'nit hazek.
thank you so much to Cheryl, Scott, Sarah, Don, David. Hope I got everybody. You may have even forgotten that you did that since you did it all last year. Let's listen again. A good and sweet year, L'Shana Tova Tikatevu, from the choir.
Yes.
L'Shana Tova Tikatevu, L'Shana Tova Tikatevu, Tikatevu. L'Shana Tova Tikatevu, L'Shana Tova Tikatevu, Tikatevu, V'Tikatevu.
And now we have reached a time in the service that everybody really waits for, the big mitzvah of Rosh Hashanah. The thing that we are commanded to do on Rosh Hashanah is to hear the sound of the shofar, because the shofar is supposed to wake us up. And if you haven't heard a shofar, you're in for a treat. It is a sound that is the same sound our ancestors heard in the wilderness and at Jericho and in Yerushalayim and in centuries since. And if you listen, if you close your eyes as Suzanne Haslow sends blows it for us, you can hear it echoing down the centuries. I this is a very, very holy moment. So Suzanne, if you will, we will all listen to you as you blow the shofar. Yashakoach. Okay, Yashakoach means good job. Okay, now we're going to talk about the goodies that come after the service. We're going to visit some homes again. And in a minute after this last visit into people's homes, we're going to have breakout groups. But before the breakout groups, we'll have the final blessing for the service. So we're going to visit some homes. We'll say a blessing, and then you will go to breakout groups to visit and to find out what's been going on with folks. So for the wine and challah or other treats you've got, we're just going to visit. You don't have to bless them. You don't have to say the blessings. We just want to visit and see. Cheryl and Dave Cleary, do you have your table for us?
I see.
You've
there.
Led music for online Shabbat, and Cheryl does a lot of work on our website. So thank you.
Cheryl's also a member of the Jewish Gateways Tabernacle Choir.
Yes. We've got Eric Strauss and Malka Whiteman, who are participants in the online Shabbat, and Catherine and Sandy Warren. Catherine is a busy volunteer. Boy, is she a busy volunteer. And Sandy is on the steering chair, is on the steering council. So Shana Tova to all of you. Thank you for welcoming us into your homes. Now I want to say a final blessing here. We've just begun the journey of the High Holy Days together, but we are going to pause for some enjoyment because it's a long road we've got to do for the next 10 days. We're going to have the blessing over wine, and it's a very simple little blessing. Remember, you can participate by saying Amen at the end of it. You get credit for the whole thing. So Joel, do you want to lead the blessings?
I would be happy to. And I'll tell you, so Sandy and Catherine are our spotlit. That's great. Anybody who has their, I forgot to pour my wine, so I just have the bottle here. And we'll sing together.
Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam borei pari hagafen.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Eternal One. Presence fills the universe, who creates the fruit of the vine.
Amen. And now the blessing over challah or any other bread you've got.
If anybody's spotly want to hold it up, that's super. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam hamotzi lechem min haaretz.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Eternal One, whose life and presence fill the universe, bringing forth bread from the earth.
Amen. Wonderful, wonderful. Okay, so we've had our blessings here. And so we're going to be going to the breakout groups. But before we do, I'd like to make a final kavanah for you, a final intention. We have begun the journey through the High Holy Days for this year. We have been through some rough years, but we are still here, and we are here to do all the work we talked about in the Aleinu. Fortunately, we don't have to do it by ourselves. We do it together. Just as this service was put together with a lot of surprises by a few people who didn't realize what they were going to be doing a week ago, the year is going to come around, and we are going to rise to the occasion. So may each of us respond when a hand reaches out. May each of us feel the joy that comes in participation in community. May there be no lonely people in our midst because they feel surrounded with light and love, to which we can say, Amen.
Amen, amen. Ken yehi ratzon. May it be God's will.
Now, enjoy your breakout groups. I will see you tomorrow morning at 10:30. And Joel will be leading the children's service at what time, Joel?
9 o'clock.
9 o'clock. So have a good visit and a good night. And thank you all so much for welcoming me into your midst.
Shkoach, Rabbi Ruth. Thank you to Christine and Eric. Thank you to just everybody, yes, on the steering council and the community involvement team. My gratitude knows no bounds.
Yes. Thank you to Joel Siegel for the music. Thank you to Lori Kirkpatrick, our community leader, and to Jim, who is right in there with her, doing wonderful stuff, to Juliana and Jim, and Ezra and Rhea, who lit candles, to Wine and Kala, the people who welcomed us into their home a few minutes ago, for those who taught us how to say Happy New Year in so many languages, Michelle and Molly and Naomi. Thank you very, very much to Christine, without whom this whole thing would have been a shambles, because she's busy making the Zoom work, because if I were running it, we would have fallen in the ditch long ago. And thank you to Adrian Bank, who was the person who called me on the phone and said, you want to do a mitzvah? So thank you for inviting me to do this mitzvah. Shana tova, everybody.
Shana tova. I'm going to thank the folks who have been sending me direct messages. I wasn't able to write back, but thank you for your messages of support and comfort. Thank you.
Let's go.
Hello.
Hey there. Shkoach. Thank you.
Christine and Eric, thank you so much. Eric, I am sorry I forgot your name. I was trying to find it on my phone and didn't have it. I will thank you tomorrow, I promise. But y'all did a beautiful job. Thank you so much.
Yeah.
I'm going to run on now and I'll get my beauty sleep because it's a long day tomorrow. Take care. Bye-bye.
Be well. Be
Take
well.
Care.
Yeah, awesome.
Cool. Did you say that you were going to take host from me tonight?
I didn't, but I can.
I can't remember. I was just about to check my email. Oh, look. Here. Hold on.
I know I've said I can be backup for that function if anybody else doesn't step up.
Huh. Yeah.
Esther, my neighbor. Okay. Not my neighbor right now because I'm in Oakland, but usually my neighbor.
So what happened is that I did not communicate well enough with Lori about what I meant for someone taking over her host. And she said that her husband, Jim, volunteered to do it.
Right.
He's a facilitator. So I think he was under the impression that he could be the host and facilitate a breakout room, which you can't do.
Just make me host. It's good. It's fine.
Are you sure? Because I can just like stick around. And
it's all good.
Okay. Then here.
And I'm seeing you. What time tomorrow am I seeing you?
8:30.
8:30,
I mean,
perfect.
I'm going to start the call at 8:30. You
okay? Yeah,
arrive when you want to.
That's about when I should be on. Perfect.
Okay, wonderful.
Okay, I see. I got a window up on my screen that has all the breakout rooms and the people in it, and I don't need to do anything. Just move that aside, I assume.
And you can just minimize it.
Okay. Doesn't have a minimize widget, but I can move it aside.
Okay.
Or close it.
If you close it, that doesn't do anything.
We have a Craig Smolin in the waiting room. Oh, did you just let him in, I guess?
I mean, there were a few hiccups, but I think it went really well.
It was great. It was fine. And I'm fine with hiccups. We acknowledge them and we move right along and we embrace imperfection.
Yep. All right.
I see. And then that I can join any of the rooms by hitting the join widget on these.
Yes. And if you do that and there's someone who like got kicked out of the breakout room and comes back to the main room, you're the only one who can put them back in their breakout room. And you
do I get a do I get a notification when that happens?
No, not when you're in a breakout room. So it's not advised. Like that's the point of having someone stick around
as
host is to be in the main room.
Got it. Okay.
All right.
That's where I'll be then. All right.
Bye.
Sleep well. Thank you again.
Thank you.
Good night, Eric. Thank you. Robert, I see you. I don't hear you. You're muted. You are welcome to stick around if you like.
All right.
You're just here in the main room with me or I can
say. Okay. Well, I was in breakout room 5, but then, had another distraction, so I wasn't sure where I should come back to.
Yeah, actually 5 is now empty.
Okay.
Let's see. I have not tried this before. I'm just gonna find a random. Oh, I see. I think I see. This is where I hop on the learning curve somewhere. Okay, Robert, I'm gonna give you a room. See you in a bit. Hi, Laura, I imagine. You are muted. If you want to talk to me, you can unmute. I'm just here in the main room monitoring to see if, are you leaving the meeting or did you get booted?
Just looking for the click, where to click to leave it.
I can never find that widget.
It's good to see you again. We've been at Jewish Gateways for about 10 years for the high holiday.
Since the beginning.
Yeah.
All right. Thank you very much.
We also remember Angela. So
thank you. Yeah.
Good evening. Thank you. You did a great job.
Take good care. Thank you. Hey, Scott. L'chaim. Hey, Jim. Hey, Scott, did you? I guess you did know that was going to happen with the chazak, because I said that I had all that material to work with from last year. Sounded good, huh? You're muted. Those harmonies at the end were sweet. You're muted still. You are.
For some reason, it doesn't. I'm having trouble getting it on and off mute. But that was great. And you could hear Sarah just floating above everybody.
Right. That's what I did. I made her float.
Yes, you did. No, and that was neat that you soloed yourself on one line so that it, you know, the rest come back in. It was great.
I'll tell you, my original goal was to give each one of us, you, me, and Cheryl, one verse. But then I realized that I had not recorded the guitar without voice.
Oh. Well, it was a real nice bite. Just yours. You know, you could have done yours a couple of times even, because then when the choir came back in, it's a real, it's got some power.
It did. Yeah, I was happy with that. Nice. Thank you for sending me that last year and it got done. Hi, Diana. If you're just white waving goodbye, we can say Shana Tova and see you maybe tomorrow. And
yes, tomorrow usually, yeah, I'm in South Berkeley and tomorrow is garbage pickup day, so I have to take my hands to the curb. Okay, bye-bye. Shana Tova.
Take good care. Shana Tova. Hi, there's some I have more neighbors, Eric and Malka. We're not neighbors right now because I'm at my sister's place in Oakland, but we're usually neighbors.
Right.
Yes.
Right.
Yes.
How did we end up here? Where are we?
We're in the main. We got.
If you leave the breakout room, you come back to the main room.
Okay.
And from there, you can hang out or leave the meeting. It looks like we're it now. The I see six participants, and I see six Hollywood squares. So I think.
Thank you, Joel. Thank you so much for sharing your beautiful voice and the music with us and tying things together. It's really lovely. Thank you.
Thank you. I'm very happy to be able to do it. On Hollywood Squares, I have dibs on being Paul Lind. That's all I can say.
And the rabbi was terrific.
Yes.
Good.
Great energy.
Yeah. Can't think of anybody better to step in and
absolutely.
You know, take the ball and run with it in the Jewish Gateways spirit. When I heard that she was doing it, you know, my blood pressure dropped 15 points and I said, and then hearing, I'm telling you, day after day after day after day, I'm like, a question would come up, I'd put it out and someone's like, okay, handled. That little issue, handled. And I know Katie was a big part of that too. Wherever you are, Katie, you've been in that home somewhere. Thank you. Another breakout room. Okay. And I mean, I'm serious. What I said, I didn't, you know, I had this real big depressive attack, and that is, you know, something I deal with.
Sorry.
And the thing that has boosted me this week, it has made all the difference in the world to watch this community
come together.
Having been empowered, you know, through Rabbi Bridget's efforts and through each of your efforts, it's you know, nobody signed up for this.
Yeah.
And,
well, you know,
and
Joel,
here it is.
We did Friday Shabbat a couple of days ago, and Eric and Malka are always there. And there's a number of us that are always there, if we're in town anyway.
Right.
And at the end of it, you know, and the rabbi wasn't there. It was really, really a nice Shabbat. It was a nice Zoom connection. And I realized, God, it's like there was almost being created a kind of a Zoom havara with all of us that throughout the COVID, you know, time. And yeah, it was wonderful. It's absolutely wonderful. So yeah. There really is a community, even when it's online.
And I think it's a tribute to Rabbi Bridget and
Amen.
The kind of feeling that she creates. She just has a way of creating just enough structure, but enough looseness.
Yeah.
And really being able to make things hold the sacred.
Mm.
You know?
When I think
while
of
we're having fun, you know.
Yeah. Speaking of structure and looseness, structure and loose and freedom, that's art. Mm-hmm. That is art in a nutshell.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You know, it's, I am overflowing.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Just my cup doth run over. It's really true. Kosi Revaya, Psalm 23. Just having fun watching everybody popping in and out, I guess.
And Joel, thank you with all you've been dealing with for pulling together and being here. And because you always have a fabulous energy and it's so appreciated that you're doing it. Thanks.
Thank you. And I'm so glad people remembering Angela.
Yeah.
Well, we're feel free to hang out. There's still lots of people in breakout rooms, so I'm here monitoring that. Nobody needs stay, but anybody's welcome. Molly, you're back to another, and there's Katie. Mm-hmm. I was singing your praises in your absence, Katie. Scott can vouch.
Thank you very much. Good night, everybody.
Good night.
Hello, Malka. You a lot.
Hi, Molly.
Good night.
We're going to go have dinner.
All right. Enjoy.
Thank you, Joel.
Thank you for everything.
Thank you.
For your soulfulness.
Yes.
Thank you.
Yes.
And thank you all for yours as well. Hey, Jim.
Hi, is this the popular kids' room?
This is where the cool kids hang out, yes.
You made it.
You need to show your cool kids card, otherwise I have to boot you from the room.
I have an iPhone, does that count?
How new is it?
Oh, no, it's very old.
Oh, that's cool then.
I think Jessica gave it to me as a hand-me-down. Oh, what a great time. And I again placed my order for that CD of the what do you call yourself, that choir?
Jewish Gateways Tabernacle Choir. We have a new member. Yehudit wants to join.
I hear you.
Oh, excellent.
I was in a breakout room with Sarah and I placed the order with her and she said something about next year when we're live. I don't know.
She says, sorry, I'm not taking orders on Rosh Hashanah.
Thank you all.
Yeah, room 6. They just can't shut up in there. It's like they got David and Cheryl and Adrian. And...
they will go on.
Yeah.
I'm going to go find Laurie. Good night, y'all.
Yeah.
All right.
Bye-bye. Guys, tomorrow morning.
You will.
Sounds good. Robert, good night. Gina, you're back.
Good night.
And good night.
Good night, Robert.
Thank you. See you tomorrow.
Good night. Catch you all tomorrow. Gina, you got a young'un coming?
Yep. Yeah. To the family service. We'll see you there.
It's Asher, right?
Yes. Yeah.
I'm working on it. See?
Yeah.
Rabbi Bridget knows every single one of these young'uns. Of course, I don't.
But, well, I'm very impressed by your memory. And we'll see you tomorrow.
Okay. Take good care.